Welcome to JE Chemistry Tutor once again. This is our 7th class on atomic structure. We are about to complete this chapter. I hope within 2-3 lectures we can cover this chapter. If you miss any of our videos, then please go and watch it on our YouTube channel. And if you like it, don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the further updates from our channel. In the last class, we talked about Schrodinger wave equation. And I have told you that solving Schrodinger equation is not a trivial task. Even for a one electron system, that is for a hydrogen atom, we need to do some mathematical special treatment to solve the Schrodinger wave equation. I told you that for solving the Schrodinger wave equation for hydrogen atom, first you have to do coordinate transformation. That is, we have to go from a Cartesian coordinate to spherical polar coordinate. Cartesian coordinate psi x, y, z that we transform into psi r, theta and phi, where r can take value that is from 0 to infinity and theta can take value 0 to pi and phi can take value 0 to 2. Now, imposing this condition into this differential equation will lead to the 3 quantum number. We can see that the solution of this Schrodinger wave equation depends on the 3 numbers, and those 3 numbers are called the quantum number. I won't go to the details of mathematical step that should be followed to solve the Schrodinger wave equation, and I think which is not important also in this stage. Rather than, I will try to emphasize on the outcome of this Schrodinger wave equation solution. Now, in this Schrodinger wave equation in the spherical polar coordinate, what we can do, we can separate that my psi r theta phi into two parts. That one is my radial part that is represented by rr and multiplied by a angular part which is represented as y theta phi. Now, while solving the Schrodinger wave equation, we can see that the energy related term is only in the radial part. So, my energy will depend on the radial part. And since in this equation, the only variable is my r. So, my energy will depend on only one quantum number, and that is my principal quantum number. And if we solve this equation, and we will get the energy expression as minus me e to the power 4 8 epsilon 0 square n square n square, where n is my principal quantum number. So we can see that my energy is only depend on the radial part, not on the angular part. It depends on the principal quantum number. Though the energy depends only on the one quantum number, that is my principal quantum number, the wave function psi, it will depend on the 3 quantum number, and that we will get from the boundary condition. And the other two quantum number, while imposing the boundary condition for theta and phi. So the angular part, y theta phi, will give birth to another two quantum numbers that is represented by L and ML, where L is called the azimuthal quantum number or subsidiary quantum number, and ML is called magnetic quantum number. Now, when we impose the boundary condition, I will get the range of possible values of L and ML. Like for a particular value of n, L can have values from 0 to n minus 1. And for a particular value of L, ML can have values plus n. Suppose n is 2, then L can have value 0 and 1. And when L is 0, that is called my s orbital. And when L is 1, that is called my p orbital. For n equal to 2, only two kinds of orbitals are possible. One is s orbital, another is p orbital. But for n equal to 3, L can have value 0, 1 and 2. For this thing, I can have 3 orbitals, that is s, p, d. And similarly for n equal to 4, I can have 4 type 4 orbital, that is s, p, d. And now you can see, when L is 0, my ML is 0. But when L is 1, my ML has values, that is minus 1, 0, plus 1. For L equal to 1, ML has value minus 1, 0, plus 1. And for L equal to 2, ML has value from minus 2 to plus 2. So we can see clearly that for a particular value of L, there are 2L plus 1 possible values of ML. Another point which I forgot to mention is that the energy expression, if I put all the constant value, it will comes out minus 13.6 divided by N square electron volt. And if we recall your Bohr atomic theory, this energy expression is same as that we got from Bohr model. But Bohr theory had different flaws. Like, it cannot explain the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. And in Bohr's theory, the path where the electron will orbit the nucleus is fixed. But a Heisenberg uncertainty principle says that it is not possible, for at least for a subatomic particle, to exactly determine the position and the velocity of that particle. So, it contradicts with Heisenberg uncertainty principle. But somehow the energy expression for the electron is same as that of what we got from Schrodinger wave equation. Now, we can see that this my psi, by the solution of Schrodinger equation psi, r theta phi, it depends on the three numbers, that is n, l and ml. And these three numbers are called quantum numbers. But, what is the physical significance of it? Why we will believe that our solution should depend on these three quantum numbers? To see this thing, we will look on some experimental fact. This experimental fact is when you studied a sharp spectral line under an external magnetic field, you will get that this sharp spectral line will split into some closely spaced line. Now, what is the origin of this thing? And the phenomena of splitting of a sharp spectral line in presence of an external magnetic field is called Zeeman effect. Now, what is the origin of this Zeeman effect? Origin of splitting of the spectral line in presence of a magnetic field is due to the interaction of the magnetic field with the dipole moment associated with the orbital angular moment. And this orbital angular momentum is quantum and its value is determined by root over of L into L plus 1 into h cot, where h cross is h upon 2. Now, since L is a quantum number and it is always an integer and it can take values from 0 to n minus 1, so this L value, the quantum number L, is ensuring that the orbital angular momentum will be quantized. Only certain values of orbital angular momentum is possible. And because of this thing, we are observing the splitting of spectral line in presence of magnetic field. Then what is the significance of the magnetic quantum number, that is ML? Now, ML represents the direction of z component of orbital angular momentum in space. How the z component of orbital angular momentum will be oriented in, and it is denoted by this expression mz, that is my ml h cross. Now, since ml have values from minus l to 0 to plus l, so that direction will also be quantized. So, it can't take any arbitrary direction. Like here, for when my l equal to 1, my ml has values minus 1, 0 and plus 1. So, when the z component of angular momentum, it will have values, that is mz is my ml into h cross. So, this is for when ml equal to 0, this is 0 and this is h cross and this is my minus l. So, what we have learned so far, we have seen that the magnetic quantum number represents the direction of the z component of angular orbital momentum in space. And the azimuthal quantum number L is the reason orbital angular momentum. And it also determines the shape of the orbital. My principal quantum number N, the energy of an electron will depend on the principal quantum number L that we have seen from the solution of the radial part. The energy expression only comes into the radial part. So, it won't be dependent on the angular part. So, n is related to the energy. And the azimuthal quantum number, that is related to the orbital angular momentum. And my ml is the direction of z component of orbital angular momentum. we have understood what is the physical significance of this quantum number. Since my Schrodinger wave equation is in three dimension, that there are only three variables, that is my r, theta and phi. So from this three variable equation, I can get only three quantum numbers, that is my n, l and m. But in 1925, there was one experiment going on. That experiment was performed by Stern and Gerlach. What is happening in this experiment? They took an silver atom. So this is a silver atom source. A beam of silver atom was passing through an inhomogeneous magnetic field. So inhomogeneous magnetic field here in the xy direction, the value of the magnetic field is constant. But in the z direction, which is the perpendicular to the path of this beam, there is a gradient of the magnetic field. Now, most of the surprising result was that while passing through this inhomogeneous magnetic field, the beam of silver atom gets deflected into only two ways. Not more than two, but only two ways. So, what is the reason behind it? Now, for the reason of a deflected beam, when some beam is passing through a magnetic field, it will deflect only if there is an interaction between the magnetic field and some magnetic moment of that beam. Now, what is the origin of this magnetic moment? What we have seen in the previous thing for the azimuthal quantum number, so there is an orbital angular momentum and the magnetic moment should be associated with the orbital angular momentum. Okay, this is fine. So, there is some orbital angular momentum because of this interaction with the magnetic field and the magnetic moment associated with the orbital angular momentum, this can be deflected. But if we look at the electronic configuration of silver atom, I didn't talk about the electronic configuration, that I will come into the next class. Believe me that the silver atom, the electronic configuration is a closed shell configuration along with a 5s1 electron. Closed shell configuration, there won't be any orbital angular momentum. And the reason I will come into later. But for time being, you believe me that for the closed shell, there won't be any orbital angular momentum. So, the orbital angular momentum, which it should come from this unpaired 5s1 electron. But, what I said that when L is 0, the orbital is S and when L is 1, that is my P. Now, for 5s orbital, my L value is 0. So, the orbital angular momentum value, it should also be 0. Because my L is root over of L into L plus 1 h cross. So, for 5s orbital, my L is also 0. So, there is no orbital angular momentum. But why then it is deflected into the two beams? The intensity of these two beams are equal. There is a 50%-50%. So, if there is 100 atoms passed through this magnetic field, there will be 50 atoms in this state and 50 atoms in this. What is the reason behind it? There is not at all any orbital angular momentum. But one thing is that to get deflected, there should be an interaction of magnetic field and the magnetic moment. Now, what is the reason for this magnetic moment? So, obviously, in this 5s electron, there is some inbuilt magnetic moment. And because of this inbuilt magnetic moment and the interaction with this inbuilt magnetic moment, the atoms got deflected into the two beams. That is also with equal intensity. Now, since only we are getting the two deflected beams, so we can see that this inbuilt angular momentum is also quantized. Because only we are getting two deflected beams and that is also with equal intensity. This inbuilt magnetic momentum is called by intrinsic . Now, what is the meaning of this intrinsic? Intrinsic means it is independent of the environment. Like it doesn't depend on the values of L. When L is 0 also, then we are getting like this. It doesn't depend on the environment. Like if you want to describe one system, obviously the mass will come. So, it is inbuilt within the system. If you talk about a charged particle, then along with the mass, the charge of the particle will come. This angular momentum is the intrinsic property of this subatomic particle. And if you do the quantum mechanical calculation, then the j component of this intrinsic angular momentum will have the value minus h cross by 2 and plus h cross by 2. Now, what we have seen for the j component of orbital angular momentum, that is my m z was ml h cross. And if you compare this with here, which is represented as sz, that is z component of intrinsic angular momentum, here it is only plus minus h cross by 2. Now, if you give like something ml h cross, just to bring similarity between the z component of the orbital angular momentum, so it will look like some plus minus, I am writing s h cross. Now, since that the z component of this intrinsic angular momentum has value only plus h cross by 2 and minus h cross by 2, so my s will have only two values, that is my plus half and then the minus half. So, this value of s is also quantized. And this we can call as another quantum number. And this quantum number is called spin quantum number. Now, when we are talking about the spin quantum number, by the name it suggests that the electron is spinning, but it is not true. And some of the textbooks you will find this thing. They talk that the spin angular momentum is arising because of the spin. That is, the electron is rotating about its own axis. But it is not true. The dimension of electron is very small. It is in the order of 10 to the power minus 12. Now, if it rotates about its own axis and the angular momentum, this intrinsic angular momentum or the spin angular momentum is coming because of this rotation, the electron should spin, the spinning velocity of the electron should be in billions times of the velocity of light. And that is not possible. So, though the name is appealing that electron can spin about its own axis, but it is not true. It is an intrinsic property of the system. There is no classical analog of this quantum number. In this context, into IIT JEE 2002, one question was asked. The question was that the quantum number means what is the significance of plus half and minus half. The option were that the rotation of electron around clockwise and anti-clockwise direction respectively. In some of the books, you will find this thing. But it is not true, which I said before also. And the option 2 was the magnetic moment of the electron pointing up, down respectively. Because in book you will find out, all the books you will find out, this is the electron spin is on this plus, this is upward spin and this is downward. But it is also not true. We represent this thing. The actual thing is, this spin angular momentum or the spin quantum number, it doesn't have any classical analog. It is totally a quantum mechanical property. We can't explain this from any classical idea. So the right answer for this question is that plus half and minus half of the electron spin represent two quantum mechanical spin states which have no classical meaning. Let's look at another question that talks about that what is the significance of this quantum number. After that, which of the following statement or is are correct about quantum number? This is actually a MSQ question. So if the value of L is 0, the electron distribution is spherical. I didn't talk about this thing. This thing I will talk in the next class. That when L is 0, that is it represents S orbital. And for the S orbital, if you look at the probability distribution of S orbital, it is totally spherical. So this is true. For time being, you believe me that this is true. That if the value of L is 0, the electron distribution is spherical. And the shape of the orbital is given by the subsidiary quantum number or L. It is also true that I told all. The Zeeman effect is explained by magnetic quantum number. It is also true in presence of the magnetic field. The spectral line is plated into many closed space line. And that is because of the interaction of the angular momentum and the magnetic field. One point is that in absence of magnetic field, the magnetic quantum number doesn't have any meaning. The magnetic name came from there. This is also true. And the spin quantum number gives the orientation of electron cloud. This is not true. So the correct answer is my A, B and C. Okay. In the next class, we will see that how my psi will look. means the wave function will look. And what is the probability distribution? Till then, bye.